Now, all the bases are not soluble in water, but those bases which are soluble in water are known as alkalis. All bases are not soluble, but which bases are soluble in water are known as alkalis. This is the basic difference between bases and the alkalis. Example of water soluble bases, it means they are water soluble, so they are also called alkalis, KOH, NaOH. And water insoluble bases are FeOH thrice and CuOH twice. Next, types: strong bases, weak bases, and it is cleared by the name only. Strong bases, they will give OH negative ion completely, and they will give OH negative ion partially when the dissolve in water. For example, sodium hydroxide, potassium hydroxide, magnesium hydroxide, and the calcium hydroxide. Next, what do all the bases have in common? In the previous video, we have discussed what do all the acids have in common. What they have? H positive ion. And what all the bases will have? OH negative ion. They will have the hydroxide ion as a common. NaOH will give Na positive and OH negative. KOH will give the K positive and OH negative. Next are the physical properties of bases. Physical properties means which we can see. They are bitter in taste, soapy to touch, turn the red litmus blue. Strong bases can cause a severe burn on the skin, that is, they are corrosive in nature, and they conduct the electricity in the aqueous medium. When any particular base we will dissolve in water and set up the experiment, then they conduct the electricity. That is, always acid and base will conduct the electricity in the aqueous medium, because in the aqueous medium ions will be formed. Acid will always form H positive ion, and bases will always form OH negative ion. Clear to you? This is the basic definition of acid and bases, which is given by the scientist Arrhenius. He gave the concept for the acids as well as bases. Clear?